Hi guys, welcome back. My name is Kyle Simon. I'm the owner of Fusion Swing Dance Studio here in Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio. It's day two of the agility challenge that Tessa and Miles Munroe have put out for this week while everybody is kind of going under lockdown due to the coronavirus. We don't want you to stop your dancing. We want you to double down and really focus on your basics and looking at a lot of those fundamental movement skills that can really help your West Coast swing dancing. Now, yesterday we were looking at foot rolling, and today what we're going to be taking a look at is how do we put on the brakes when we're trying to move through foot rolling. So the first thing that we're going to look at, this is kind of one of three with putting on the brakes, is learning how to slow your roll. Now, what that means is that we never want to, I turn to the side, you never want to see your foot just fall super fast, right? You want to control how quickly you get from the toe of your foot to the heel of your foot. Now, in order to do that, you will have to engage muscles in your calf and in your quad to control that movement, but it should be very smooth, okay? So that's correct. We never want to see us fall flat-footed onto that foot. Sometimes you get people marching, and it's really about controlling the weight transfer. So number one, slow your roll. Number two is that we have to control our center, okay? If we have our foot extended and our toe is hitting the floor, if we moved our center quickly over our foot, boom, our foot hits very quickly. But if we control the way our center, kind of rationing it to take our time to get over that foot, it slows us down, okay? So we have to control our center as we move it and shift it over that foot, okay? Now finally, in order to slow things down, look at this other leg. We are gonna use this almost as a brake to draw in, collect underneath us, and then be able to move in any direction that we choose, okay? So if we put it all together, we're always gonna have the foot extended out outside of our body first, then we're gonna ration our center by slowly moving that weight over. And then once you get to this position, we're going to use this leg that doesn't have any weight on it to slowly draw in. Now you can press down into the floor to almost create friction, 2 to 3 pounds of pressure into the floor to create friction to control your speed and then be able to move in any direction. Once we do this, if we control the weight transfer and draw our foot in and collect, we could move forward. If we did it again, we could move to the side. There's so many different ways that you can take that movement once you collect it underneath you. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and get a prop real quick. The next thing we're gonna be talking about is how we move our center, okay? Now, right now, if I have weight on both of my feet, my center, I'm gonna use this piece here, my center is right in the center of my body based on where this line is. Now, if I shift my center over this foot, and I keep my center moving past the foot, well, it's gonna take me past that foot. Same thing, if I transition my weight over to my left foot here and keep going, it's gonna make me continue to move in that direction. So that's one option for your center, is to move past the foot. Now, another option would be to put the center directly over the foot and stop. Now I'm balanced over this foot. Okay, I have full weight over my left foot. If I did it again this way, all of my weight is over my right foot, okay? So this would be a full weight transfer. Now, what a lot of people struggle with in West Coast swing is partial weight transfers. What does that mean? Well, if I start to put pressure into my left foot, but I don't take my center over it, what happens is that my weight or my center falls back to the place that it started, falls back onto my right foot. So you can think of this as a partial step, right? Partial step. If I had taken my weight fully over this foot, I would have balanced. Now, the problem with this is that this is a very slow and sluggish movement. And in West Coast swing, our triple steps are typically, our rhythm is quick, quick, slow. So the partial steps allow you to be quick, quick, quick. We go the other way, quick, quick, right? If you look at it going forward, it's the same thing. Quick, quick. You're able to position yourself and move quicker by not shifting the weight over the step. Quick, 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 right? So keep that in mind as you're moving through any of the B drills that we're gonna do next, is that in order to be quick with our rhythm, quick, quick. The foot can go down, but the center cannot shift over the foot. So the first thing we're gonna do is take a look at our B drill. And what I want you guys to do at home is think about making very large movements. And don't worry about straightening this leg to be what we call an international leg, is when you commit the weight to a straight leg. It's okay to be bent on that supporting leg for this drill. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna do the B drill and go in multiple directions. So think of this as here, and you're drawing that leg in to slow you down. So you're gonna be applying all of those positions, right? Slow your roll, control your center, and then provide a little bit of pressure into the floor with the other leg to slow you down. So if we did our B drill, and we're trying to make this as big as we can. Awesome, guys. So just kind of keep that in mind as you're trying to control your body. Now, in step two, let's go ahead and add our rhythm, our quick, quick, slows, right? So if we think about this as our quick, quick, slow, we can see that we're pulling that foot in. Again, quick, quick, slow, 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 quick, quick, slow. You're controlling that movement throughout the entire thing. Excellent, guys. Good job. So as you complete those first couple stages of doing the B drill, what we're going to do now is we're going to put on some music and add another layer of complexity to it with a little bit of music. You can go in any direction here, guys. A lot of times, once you get some music, you can play around with it, add in some other footwork, whatever you're feeling with music, but focus on your B drill. This is really just training your body to dance and move in any direction. Now for the last part of this drill, I want you to get a glass of water, glass of coffee, or some wine. I only have a bottle of water, but try not to spill it. You're adding in another level of connection to isolate this part of your body. Guys, excellent, excellent job today. Again, today we learned about slowing our roll, controlling our center, using our other foot to slow us down. We also learned about full weight transfers as well as partial weight transfers based on where we move our center, okay? So keep working on these things, keep working on the foot rolling. It's such a critical part of West Coast swing that if you really dial it in here while we are at home, under the coronavirus shutdown right now, you can really make a ton of progress in your West Coast swing dancing. Again, thank you to Tessa and Miles Munroe for pumping out all of this awesome content so we can continue our West Coast swing journey here over the next 2 to 4 weeks. And until then, we'll kind of wait until day 3 and we'll see some more videos tomorrow. Until then, have a great day, guys.